Diablo 3 is the sequel to Blizzard's hit multi-million dollar selling RPG, Diablo 2. The series this game originates from has been long praised by PC gamers as being one of the best RPGs to ever grace the PC gaming platform. Ever! So can this new chapter into the series fulfill all the wishes that these gamers have had for so long to see a sequel to their favorite game? Probably not. But let's take a look anyway. Diablo 3 is a fantasy game where you view your character from an isometric overhead view and use your mouse to drive the whole game, from moving to attacking. The main draw of the Diablo series is the randomly generated dungeons and the loot that you find. The main thing pushing you to play the game is to clear these randomly generated dungeons that are new every time, and to get better gear and to head towards the end of the game to kill Diablo. Diablo 3 makes a few notable improvements over Diablo 2. Mainly convenience things in the gameplay that were a little bit annoying in the prequel. In Diablo 3, you can run wherever you want for as long as you want, whereas in Diablo 2, you had a sprint bar that you had to stand still to let refill, which was a little obnoxious and didn't really add to the gameplay. In Diablo 3, you can also pick up gold just by running over it with your character, whereas in Diablo 2, you had to click on the gold piles to pick them up. So these are just two little things to make the gameplay a little bit more convenient and less tedious. Unfortunately, in my opinion, these are the only two gameplay improvements really in the game. Besides this, there's modern sounds in the game that do sound good, and then there's, I guess, technically improved graphics. While the graphics are technically better, they have this style to them that I really don't like. If you compare the styles of the two games, you'll note that Diablo 2's style is really loose, and you would really have trouble calling it as a style, because it's more of a graphical attempt to make a 2D game look 3D. But in Diablo 3, the game goes for a really almost cartoony World of Warcraft style. The only major difference between World of Warcraft and this game is that this game has darker lighting and a darker overall palette. But besides that, it's clear they just threw the same artists onto this game that they had for World of Warcraft. It's a little upsetting. It seems lazy, especially when StarCraft 2 didn't really resemble World of Warcraft. Why couldn't they have done the same thing here? One of the coolest things about Diablo 2 is that you could move around almost the entire act that you were in and do whatever you wanted. While later parts would require you to complete quests, for the most part you could just go around and do what you want. If you didn't want to bother picking up quests at the very beginning, you could just head forward into the wild and attack some monsters, collect loot, and level up. Diablo 3, though, clamps down on your freedom. It's constantly gating you and preventing you from moving forward to a point where the game doesn't want you to be. Look, here's an example right here. I just got into town, and now this old drunk guy won't let me go anywhere forward until I bring a parcel to Professor Oak. I understand that the purpose of gating is to prevent players from going out into an area they're not ready for and to having a really unfun time with the game, but there's better ways to do it than just outright putting a brick wall in front of you. Look at how Diablo 2 did it. In the first area, as you're about to head out into the wilderness, there's a guard telling you that you really shouldn't go out there, you're not high enough leveled. But you can ignore the bitch and go out and do it anyway. And you know what happens?
Holy fucking Jesus!
Get your ass kicked! And guess what? That's okay! Because the game told you, hey, you're not gonna have fun out there. But you did it anyway, and now you know, now you understand. What if you're a game veteran and you want to go out there and try something new right off the bat? In Diablo 2, you can do that, but in Diablo 3, you gotta play along with the theme park tour and do whatever it wants until you're finally let loose to go and do what you want. On top of this, Diablo 3 throws on a lot more scripted events and a ton more cutscenes than were in Diablo 2. Fortunately, though, Diablo 3 lets you skip any cutscene, which I am very grateful for. Now, no offense to anyone who appreciates Diablo's story, it's just kind of a personal preference of mine for this series to concentrate more on the gameplay. When I played through the original Diablo and Diablo 2 with my friends, we mostly just skimmed over all the story and cutscenes and focused on dungeoneering and enjoying the game's gameplay. When I said that there was only two positive gameplay changes in the game, I wasn't implying that there was only two gameplay changes, period. No, what I'm saying is that there's only two gameplay changes that I really felt were good. The rest of the gameplay changes, and there's plenty of them, gave me a chill. Get it? Because the guy just froze. The inventory system in this game has been turned into a joke. In the original Diablo and Diablo 2, you had to very carefully manage your inventory. Different items were different sized. tunics were larger than swords, swords were larger than potions, and you had to move things around in your inventory in a way to make sure you had enough room. On top of this, you also had to manage when you were going back to town to sell your stuff or store items. And in order to go to town, you needed to make sure you had enough town scrolls, and you also had to make sure you had enough scrolls of identification on you to identify new items you found. But in Diablo 3, they've just trashed all of this. Most items take up only 2 slots in your inventory, which, by the way, has seemed to have ballooned into an enormous size. Also, teleporting to town and identifying items no longer requires a scroll. You can just do it whenever you want. This takes out a lot of difficulty in the game, as inventory management was a big part of the original Diablo. Furthermore, I don't understand why there's still a identifying item system in the game if you can just do it for free. Why not just have the items automatically have their stats on them then? The penalty for death in Diablo 3 has also been greatly reduced. In Diablo 2, when you died, you went all the way back to town. Every time. And on top of that, you lost a bunch of gold. But in Diablo 3, when you die, you merely get sent back to a checkpoint, usually just a few steps away from where you died. And you merely just lose 10% of your armor durability. Usually, this can actually work to your advantage, as you're suddenly right next to the group of monsters you were fighting with full health, and you're able to go through and just finish them off most of the time. When the punishment for death can feel like a reward, you've done something wrong. The leveling system in Diablo 3 has also been greatly dumbed down. In the original Diablo 2, you had 4 different attributes to put points into every time you leveled up. You also had 3 skill trees to select new abilities from. You could not have every ability in the game for your character. You had to plan out a character and pick those abilities as you were going. Now, this sounds a little harsh, but there's opportunities in the game to reset your skills and abilities, so if you make a bad choice, it's not the end of the world. But in Diablo 3, you don't get to pick where your skill points go. You just level up. On top of that, the ability system works in a way that you basically get every ability for your class. You can't have them all active at the same time, but you get all the abilities and you can just choose between them in the middle of battle. This is very easy and I don't like it.
What's the matter, kids? You didn't take your ADD medicine today? That's okay, we'll keep your attention.
You blew a thing up.
Oh, you killed a monster? You just did a
massacre.
What's that? You're gonna go kill another one?
Well, massacre.
What? You don't want to kill monsters right now? You wanna break a barrel? Alright, you just did a
destruction.
Oh, you're kicking ass, kids.
Holy shit.
Perhaps the stupidest addition to Diablo 3 is these health spheres that you find laying around after you kill monsters. Running into these refills your health. Why were these put in the game? Health potions serve this purpose already, and there's still health potions in the game. Why have 2 methods to refill your health? This just makes it really, really redundant. Like, why bother with potions when these health spheres are most likely gonna drop from enemies? The difficulty curve in this game is all sorts of fucked up. At the beginning of the game, you basically can't die. Monsters are ultra weak and you can just rip through them like they're nothing. But at the end of the first act, you suddenly start to feel woefully underpowered, and monsters actually start to kill you. And at the beginning of the second act, you are gonna get your ass kicked. Now, I'm not a terrible video game player, I'm not the best, but I don't think this comes down to skill. I think this comes down to a method from Blizzard to make you spend more time in the game. It almost feels like at this point they want you to start grinding. I don't think that's acceptable. I don't remember having to grind at all in Diablo 2. Me and my friends would just keep playing forward, and we would never really have a dead end where we couldn't progress. We would just keep on moving. But in Diablo 3, you feel like you have to go back and grind so you can continue. That's terrible. If the difficulty originates from not being skilled enough at the game, that's fine. That gives you a chance to play more and to enjoy the game better because you suddenly get better at it. But when the difficulty comes from your numbers aren't big enough, that's not fun. One of my biggest complaints about Diablo 3 is the random generation. Here, look at this. This is the overworld in the first act, close to town with one character. Now here it is with another character. Notice anything different? Me neither. Actual dungeon layouts do vary between characters, but you'll notice a lot of rooms that look identical to other rooms in other versions of that dungeon. Smaller dungeons like this, you'll notice little to no difference. The item placement might be different, but who cares? In Diablo 2, everything was effectively randomly generated on the overworld. Look, in this instance, here's the town, then you exit to the east, and you head north through this field. There's a large area blocked off in the middle, and then there's a cave. In this separate instance of the same area, you have to exit south over a moat. There's a cave directly at the beginning, and then to advance, you have to head east. In this third instance, you exit town westward. I have no idea where the cave is, and then you have to go north to get out of here. Occasionally, you will run into a dungeon that has the same layout regardless, such as the Den of Evil, but the randomly generated dungeons greatly outnumber them. Look at the layout of this same dungeon in three different games. It's radically different each time. I really doubt you will notice a room being reused while you're playing. Overall, Blizzard should be ashamed of how the randomly generated areas in Diablo 3 turned out. It's like they took all the progress they made in Diablo 2 and just turned it way, way, way back. I don't understand.
Okay, wait a second. What's going on here? Where are we going? Okay, let's wait a second. Oh! Hey, oh! Well, isn't that just fucking disgusting?
Just fuck off. Jesus Christ, when's this stupid fucking internet fad gonna be over?
Last, but most certainly not least, is the Real Money Auction House. Blizzard implemented a system into Diablo 3 that lets users trade items with each other on a big auction house. There's an option to use real money instead of in-game gold here. You can buy gold and items for United States dollars here. Blizzard justified this feature as a way to combat gold farmers. Chinese websites that try to sell you items and gold in a really dodgy fashion. But in reality, Blizzard's making bank off this. They get a cut out of everything sold. They have their fingers in all your pockets and they're just making money off of you using this. A game should be about fun first and foremost. But when you have a system in your game like this, it's gonna affect that. Blizzard has already put out numerous patches that have changed the way loot drops, just so that there's more rare items that people can sell in their auction house that will make them money. This is negatively affecting your user experience. Now naturally, a company's main motivation for putting a game out is to make money off of it. But when you sell a game, a not free-to-play game, you make money off of that once, off of the user's purchase. If you're trying to continuously milk the user for money after you've already sold the game to them, then that's not right. Blizzard tries to sell you these mobile authenticators that are supposed to make your account more secure because you can't log in without the device. Only problem with that is that doesn't really work when Blizzard goes and gets their asses hacked and has, you know, all your email addresses leaked out. Your answers to your personal security questions leaked out, information regarding the mobile and dial-in authenticators leaked out, and your scrambled passwords leaked out as well. See, in that case, it's never worth $650, I don't think. On top of this, the game has a very terrible DRM system in order to make sure this auction house works. You always have to be online to play Diablo 3. Even when you're playing single player, you have to be connected to the internet. This means when the servers are laggy, when there's maintenance, when stuff is happening to the internet, you won't be able to play. This isn't acceptable under any circumstances. This is the worst thing Blizzard has done with Diablo 3 and the biggest reason why you should not buy Diablo 3. The original series creator of Diablo, David Brevik, went to do a little interview where they talked about Diablo 3 a bit, and David Brevik gave off some of his criticisms about the game in a very calm, tame, reasonable manner. So of course the big crying babies in the Diablo 3 dev team had to post that on their Facebook and say such reasonable things back, such as, "Fuck that loser." It just goes to show how awful the people who made Diablo 3 actually are. Overall, gamers, don't buy Diablo 3. And tell your friends not to buy it either. Best stick with the original. But only if you already have it. Like, Blizzard is still selling Diablo 2 for the ridiculous fucking price of $20. And honestly, at this point, Blizzard doesn't deserve any of your money. So if you don't already own Diablo 2, Torchlight 2 just came out. Go get that instead.